never done it, but then relative thought.
Two. Two. Guys are so far away.
That's the way they're supposed to.
I know we're supposed to be distanced. I totally get it. Hope you can hear us. I know those VIP tickets are expensive. They're like $5 now just to get people in. I think we're live on Facebook. What a fabulous opening set by Fred Rosen. Can we give him a hand if you were here to hear that? We've got a nice Pipestem crowd. Guys are hanging out. That was a wonderful thing. Fred and Lori, you should be real proud of that. I know that Fred was really excited about it. And it was just great. The Billy Joel brought me back. I was telling Carrie next door, Billy Joel was a part of my high school, especially Just the Way You Are. It was like a basement, dark makeout song for us in like, what, sophomores? That's all, just making out. Nothing crazier yet. I went late.
Fran, what are you doing up there?
I know. We have Fran's tree behind us. There's a little bit of a nice celebration, the reason that tree is there, too. My daughter, Kelly Hauk, graduated from high school this past Thursday. Can I give her a hand? Can we get a hand?
Woo! Go, Kelly!
Class of 2020. I mean, come on. Can you imagine? Everybody in college and high school is going through the class of 2020, and they did a relatively socially distanced graduation. We were a little bit like, I don't know about the handshakes with the diploma.
Well, what do I do about it?
I don't know.
So that tree, Fran, has extra meaning. So thank you. Thank you. Port St. Joe, Florida has represented Port St. Joe High School and my girl. Let's kick this thing off. Hello, Facebook. Hello, Pipestem. It is Bob Dylan's birthday, by the way. He turns 79 years old today, believe it or not. And as a musician and any music writer as I am, and anybody who's loved music for 50 years, Bob is part of our fabric. So let's begin this evening with Bob, all right? Let's do it. Come gather around people wherever you roam, and admit that the water around you have grown, and accepted that soon you'll be drenched to the bone. If your time's worth saving, then you better start swimming. You'll sink like a stone, for the times they are a-changing. Come on. Will come writers and critics, prophesize with your pen. Then keep your eyes wide, the chance won't come again. And don't speak too soon, for the wheel's still to spin. No telling who that it's naming, for the loser now will be later to win. For the times, they are changing. Come senators and congressmen, please heed the call. Don't stand in the doorway, don't block up the hall. For he that gets hurt will be he who is stalled. And the battle outside raging will soon shake your windows and rattle your walls. For the times, they are a-changing. But we'll get through it. Will come mothers and fathers throughout the land, and don't criticize what you don't understand. Your sons and your daughters are beyond your command. Your old road is rapidly aging. Please get out of the new one if you can't lend a hand. For the times, they are a-changing. Tonight. Well, the line it is drawn and the curse it is cast. Well, the slow one now will later be fast, as the present now will later be past. Well, the order is rapidly fading, and the first one now will later be last, for the times they are a-changing. For the times they are a-changing. Happy birthday, Bob. Robert Zimmerman, to be exact. Hey, thanks. You're outside. Oh my God. Outside and enjoying each other from a distance. It's nice to have people around. We did this a week or so ago, and we love our neighbors, and we love everybody coming down the Pipestem, and our direct next-door neighbors right here. It's so nice to have you directly there. It's love you guys. This is a pretty intense time, and we're going to have some fun. There's some songs we didn't play last weekend because we want to have some fun. We're doing a few extra ones, and let's do this one from R.E.M. Walls are built up, stone by stone. The fields divided one by one. And the train conductor says, take a break, driver eight. Driver eight, take a break. We've been on this ship too long. And the train conductor says, take a break, driver eight. Driver eight, take a break. We can't reach our destination. We're still a ways away. We're still a ways away. I saw a treehouse on the outskirts of the farm. The power lines have floaters so the airplanes won't get snagged. Bells are ringing through the town again. Children look up, all they hear is sky blue bells ringing. And the train conductor says, take a break, driver eight. Driver eight, take a break. We can't reach our destination. We're still a ways away. Still a ways away. Still a ways away. Still a ways away to shield the hated heat. Way to put myself to sleep. Ah, the way to shield the hated heat. A way to put myself, my children to sleep. Ha. He piloted this song in a plane like that one. She is selling faith on the Go-Tel Crusade. Locomotive 8, a Southern Crescent. Hear the bells ring again. Field to weed is looking thin. Thin, thin, ha! And the train conductor says, take a break, driver 8. Driver eight, take a break. You know we've been on this shift too long. And the train conductor says, take a break, driver eight. Driver eight, take a break. We can't see our destination. Still a ways away. Still a ways away. Still a ways away. Michael Stipe and the boys who have been a presence. Michael has been a presence during this thing, of course, with a song. Oh, what about it, Michael? But he's come on and he's written a couple songs, done some stuff on his porch with a friend doing the music track. So we love R.E.M. And Suzanne went to get her doctorate at the University of Georgia right in Athens, where they're from. So it's part of her life. All right, here's one. I got to sing at a tribute at Jam and Java about a year or so ago, a Beatles tribute. They did it on the day of the anniversary of the Beatles playing the rooftop in London, in Ivy Road. And they had a great, huge, amazing lineup, and they asked me to do it. I was stunned and happy, and I got to sing Let It Be, and a couple other ones, and this was one of them. And it's a beauty. Here we go. I look at all right, ready?
Yep.
1, 2, 3, 4. I look at all the lonely people. I look at all the lonely people. Eleanor Rigby picks up the rice in the church where the wedding has been. She lives in a dream, lives in the window, wearing a face that she keeps in a jar by the door. Who is it for? All the lonely people. Where do they all come from? All the lonely people. Where do they all belong? Father McKenzie writing the words of a sermon that no one will hear. No one comes near. Look at him working, donning the socks in the night when there's nobody there. What does he care? All the lonely people. Where do they all come from? All the lonely people. Where do they all belong? I look at all the lonely people. I look at all the lonely people. Eleanor Rigby died in the church and was buried along with her name. Nobody came. Father McKenzie wiping the dirt from his hands as he walks from the grave. No one was saved. All the lonely people. Where do they all come from? I say, all the lonely people. Where do they all belong? There you go. From the Beatles. Got to do that. Hello, Flo. Hello, guys. Good to see you. Flo and Nito, a fantastic musician in her own right. So we better step it up. Just had Flo on my my new online music show called Living on Music. It's on Monday nights at 7 on ZTV, which is an Alexandria Media conglomerate of sorts, and they've launched their network, and Flo was generous enough to have her. To have be on my show, and we had a great 45 minutes. What's that? Flo is right there in the white sweater, just sitting down.
Say hi to Flo. Everybody say hi to Flo.
Floanito.com. Repeat, Floanito.com. Flo and I met Flo at the Fillmore when we did a David Bowie tribute. And Flo is a lifetime musician and like just superb, and all these people. And I'm a kind of midlife cover band guy, and they asked me to do it, and I'm like. And I walked in, and there's people like Flo and the Sidleys, who are on with me tomorrow night on my show, and Eric Scott, who's on in a couple weeks, and these amazing local musicians, and we nailed it. Although I did forget part of a verse, and I swore I wasn't going to use lyrics, and I didn't, and I brought them out, and I forgot the little part. You couldn't really tell. And then I didn't, I brought the lyrics out for the second song we did, Blue Jean, and I didn't need him, so you just never know. But Flo, thank you for being here. Both of you guys, thanks so much for coming. This is a song Ricky Nelson wrote. It was after a really tough situation that kind of almost shelved his career, pretty much. He was pretty big after doing Ozzy and Harriet with his parents, and then he went out on a music career and had a kind of a crooning, kind of pretty boy, nice career as a singer, and then went to Madison Square Garden to play one night in front of people like George Harrison, and Yoko Ono was there, and tremendous amount. Chuck Berry was playing, and he and his band dressed like hippies. They had longer hair and different clothes, and people shunned them. And it was very odd, and he had played the same songs he always has, and people were very dismissive of his changing his image. So he wrote this classic song that's kind of melancholy but beautiful, and this goes out to Rick Nelson.
And I had no idea it was about Madison Square Garden.
Thank you. I went to a garden party to reminisce with my old friends. A chance to share old memories and play our songs again. When I got to that garden party, they all knew my name, but no one recognized me. I didn't look the same, but it's all right now. I learned my lesson well. You see, you can't please everyone, so you got to please yourself. People came from miles around, everyone was there. Yoko brought a walrus, there was magic in the air. And over in the corner, much to my surprise, George Harrison, Mr. Hughes, he hid in Dylan's shoes, wearing his disguise. And all right now, I learned my lesson well. You see, you can't please everyone, so you got to please yourself. La da da da, la da da da, la da da da. La da 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 da. Da, 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 da. I played them all the old songs. I thought that's why they came. No one heard the music, 'cause we didn't look the same. I said hello to Mary Lou, she belongs to me. But when I sang a song about a honky-tonk, ha, it was time to leave. But it's all right now, learn my lesson well. You see, you can't please everyone, so you got to please yourself. La da da da, la da da da, la da 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 da, la da 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 da. Someone opened up a closet door. Out stepped Johnny B. Goode. He was playing guitar like ringing a bell, and looking like he should. If you gotta play a garden party, I wish you a lot of luck. But if memories were all I sang, I'd rather drive a truck. And it's all right now, you know, I learned my lesson so well. You see, you can't please everyone, so you got to please yourself. You see, you can't please everyone, so you got to please yourself.
Ricky Nelson, ladies and gentlemen. A great career and a really tough night for him. And Mr. Hughes in Dylan's Shoes was George Harrison in Bob Dylan's shoes that he actually had for something, who God knows. You know, so, but they were in the Wilburys later, so maybe it was fortuitous. Hey, how is everybody doing? You guys feeling okay? You feeling good back there? Thumbs up from Fred's driveway. Love you guys. The Spences. And we love all you guys for coming actually in here and hunkering down with us in the driveway in the Pipestem. We called it the Pipestem Concert. Fred Rosen, again, if you were here, let's give Fred a hand, because if you weren't, you missed a real special thing, and it's going to be on Fred Rosen's Facebook page. But he's got some, I think it's Fred Rosen 7A dot something. But I'll post it, and it was wonderful. He did some sax, and he's a wonderful player. I was waiting till Fred was around, if he's up there, to talk about how he got back doing sax again.
Well, through conversation, I don't know if Fred's there or not, but through conversations with Fred, I play the clarinet. Many of you may or may not know that I play the clarinet, and I took a break for about 30 years, joined a local community band associated with Fairfax County. I learned that Fred played saxophone. I said, oh, come on, pick up your saxophone and join us. Took me probably about 3 years of talking to him to get him to join us again, but he is and I are both in the Main Street Community Band, and we will be hopefully playing concerts again next year. That's my guess.
Yeah, it was great stuff. He did a little. He did some jazz. He did some Billy Joel, which, again, took me right way back. It was some wonder. Even did Let It Go, Let It Go, Let It Go. And we saw the little skater going down the middle of the Pipestem in our minds. We were talking the other day about some of the live shows that we had seen right before this thing hit, and we'd really saw some killer shows. Grace Potter is a buddy of mine, and we saw Grace and hung out with her after the show at the at the Anthem. We were able to see probably the best show of the group, the Drive-By Truckers, with Patterson Hood, one of the great, great American songwriters of our time. I've interviewed him twice, and we saw him at the 9:30 Club. Remember that place? Ah! Got to get back there.
Damn. That was a great
show. Missed these venues. And we were standing on the rail and fighting people who would come up and try to take our spot. It was like being, 18 again.
It was like being back in Athens.
And that was probably the best. But I got to interview Jeremiah Freitas of the Lumineers, we got to go see them right before this hit. They've been selling out arenas after 15 years of really working hard, the two of them. And they met they were Ramsey, New Jersey buddies. And they got to play Madison Square Garden. That's why I bring this up. And can you imagine two guys from Ramsey in their mid-30s going to play Madison Square Garden, and they couldn't believe it. And they walked backstage, and there was a framed picture of Pearl Jam, Eddie Vedder, and on the bottom it said, Eddie had said, if you don't play the Garden, you ain't shit. I've been to the Garden many times. I'm from Connecticut. But these guys were fabulous. They're a great young band. Not young. They've been kicking ass for a while, and now they're world famous, and they had to take a break. Here's a song called Gloria. Gloria, I smell it on your breath. Gloria, it's some booze and some peppermint. Gloria, no one said enough is enough. Gloria, they found you on the floor. Gloria, you know my hand was tied to yours. And Gloria, did you finally see that enough is enough? Come on. Did you know me when I was younger then? I could take the whole world with me. I would find myself feeling alone. Heaven help me now, heaven show the way. Get me back on my own two feet. I would lie awake and pray you won't lie awake for me. Oh, 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 oh. Your cross, Gloria, you know you made us sit and watch. I said, Gloria, no one said enough is enough, right? Is enough, is enough. Hey, come on, everybody. Heaven help me now, heaven show the way. Get me back on my own two feet. I will lie away. Pray you don't lie away for me. Every night away, every day alone, everybody on my own two feet. I will lie away and pray you don't lie away for me. Oh, 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 oh. Just decide, Gloria, you know there's easier ways to die. Gloria, have you had enough? Had enough? Gloria, Gloria, had enough? Had enough? Gloria, had enough? Had enough? Gloria. Hey, we are able to delve out of the 1970s occasionally. That's off an album called Three. It's their third album, I believe. And what a great band. And we went and saw them, and it was very revivalist. It was very, they walk around, they play these drum things, and they just walk around the ramps with five or six of them. It's a great band. So I hope they come back too. Wesley Schultz, their lead singer, has been doing some online stuff. for Colorado, because they're having a obviously big, big hit too. And they've been doing some stuff for local venues. So cheers to the Lumineers. So I grew up in the 70s. Anybody else grew up in the 70s? Late 70s? Close. Wait, what?
78.
78 here too? 78. 78, 78. 7777. Oh, that's what they used to do.
You were born in 78?
In the 70s.
One of my heroes in my, since I've been singing for about 15 years and you know, cover bands around here, is Bob Seger. He is still singing, still playing. Really one of the greats, the great songwriters and singers of our era. And this is a great song we're going to kind of do, which we haven't done in a while. It's from Against the Wind, and it's called Still the Same.
We write in?
No, I haven't.
Okay.
No problem. Go for it. You always won. Every time was sure they had you caught. You were quicker than they thought. You just turned your back and walked. You always said the cards would never do you wrong. The trick, you said, was never play the game too long. A gambler's share, the only risk that you would take. The only loss you could forsake. The only bluff you couldn't fake. And you're still the same. I caught up with you yesterday. Moving game to game. No one standing in your way. Turning on the charm. Long enough to get you by. Well, you're still the same. You still aim high. Still the same. Still the same. Still the same. Still the same. There you stood. Everybody watched you play. I just turned and walked away. Because I had nothing left to say. Cause you're still the same. You're still the same. Still the same. Moving game to game. Still the same. Some things never change. Cause you're still the same. You're sweet. Thanks. See, you can actually cheer for live music. And make us feel good and make yourselves feel good. Thanks so much, you guys. That's a great one. I love Bob. We have so many memories and so many times. I was at the Boston Garden when I was in college at BU, and we were sitting on one of those little ledge seats, and he did turn the page, and before he came and sat in his piano, he looked right up at us, and he just went, remember? Yeah, Fran's song. And he looked up at us and waved right at the three of us, me and Bruce Fowler and his girlfriend. I'll never forget. But we love Bruce.
We'll do that.
Sometime, I promise.
Okay.
No, at some point, some band. Turn the page.
Not yet. I'm gonna go.
What's that? Sure. Once again, Fred Rosen, thanks so much for opening up. What a fabulous jazz show. And Fred's, you know, it's just, again, it's part of getting out and doing music. There's Lori. Where are you guys? You guys are inside talking about the gig. And he's, you know, anybody who can get out and play extra music right now, especially. And as I said before, Fred and Suzanne are in the Main Street Community Band, a huge, wonderful band that plays shows all over the place. All year long, and they are hurting too. There's about, what, 60 members of your orchestra, Suzanne? And Fred and Suzanne are in the band together. And again, Suzanne plays clarinet. But what a great opening set. So thanks, Fred. And it wasn't really an opening set. It was his own set. This is a song by a guy named Tim Hardin. He was a brilliant songwriter of the 60s. He appeared at Woodstock. He was not in the movie, but he did this song at Woodstock. Wrote a number of great songs like Reason to Believe from Rod Stewart, which is one of my favorite songs. Bobby Darin has covered this. Johnny and June did a great version. The Four Tops did probably the most successful version. Leon Russell, Bob Seger. But this is a beautiful song from Tim Hardin. We lost him in the early 80s, and it's too bad. And we'll honor his memory with this beautiful song called If I Were a Carpenter. If I were a carpenter and you were a lady, would you marry me anyway? Would you have my baby? If a tinker were my trade, would you still find me carrying the pots I made and following behind me? Save my love through loneliness and save my love for sorrow. I'm giving you my onlyness. Give me your tomorrow. Come on. If I worked my hands in wood, would you still love me? Answer me, babe. Oh God, yes I would. I'd put you above me. If I were a miller at a mill wheel grinding, would you miss your color box and your soft shoe shining? Save my love through loneliness, save my love through sorrow. I'm giving you my onlyness. Give me your tomorrow. All right. If I were a carpenter and you were a lady, would you marry me anyway? Would you have my baby? Would you marry me anyway? Would you have my baby? Tim Hardin, he deserves it all. I mean, a carpenter has to beg a little bit. I mean, you know, I wish I were a carpenter and fix everything. I can't fix anything.
I wish that too. Oh.
Kidding. Ouch.
Thanks again for hanging, you guys, here in the Pipestem. We did have, ladies and gentlemen, the delivery is here from a guy who's not a delivery guy. He runs three amazing restaurants in this area. Let's give it up for Eddie Santiago, please. Villa Bella. You've heard of Villa Bella, you've heard of Giardino, and you've heard of Paradiso. Hey, brother! I'd hug you and kiss you right now if I could, but we'd get chastised and we'd get in trouble.
Well, you guys are awesome. Thank you so much. You know, this is amazing. I wish more people to do this kind of stuff. If we can be help for anything at all.
Well, thank you so much. Let me tell something about Eddie Santiago, who is not only a restaurateur, but an incredible trumpet player. And he went to college for trumpet, actually, and then has done other amazing business things. But we're trying to get, I want to see you play trumpet sometime soon. But Eddie, actually, we play gigs at Paradiso and Giardino, and he has been so open and wonderful. I love you, man. I miss you out there.
Oh, man, thank you.
But boy, talk about being out there and doing stuff and trying to continue business, man. We'll keep pushing you.
I have a trunk full of beer and wine if anybody...
Whoa, stampede! Jesus.
I've got truly...
Roll them.
Spare winds. I've got wine. That's what I do. You know, I got to anticipate your needs. So happy Memorial Day.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for letting me be part of it. Okay?
Eddie Santiago.
Seriously, though, I do have a truck full of
people. I love you, man. Hey, Eddie, thank you, man. And Eddie's got a family, and every day you see him with his beautiful children, and so he's trying to do business and be a family like a lot of you guys are. So love you, Eddie. Thanks, man, so much. Wow. And we got a za. We've got a za. And by the way, I know, really, beer and wine in his trunk. I might run up there. Suzanne will do a little classical gas. Remember that?
Yeah.
For you guys. You know, when I first saw that song, I first actually remember seeing that song on the Ed Sullivan Show, and that's how old I am, or, you know, experienced, I guess I'd rather
reruns.
Call it.
It was the reruns.
No, it wasn't. It was original. And he started that, you know, he started out at the beginning on an acoustic, and then when it, and the whole curtain went up, and it was a full orchestra, and I was just like, I love music. I love it. By the way, if you weren't here last weekend,
why are you drinking the hand sanitizer?
We have hand sanitizer right here, which isn't really. It's actually.
I guess something.
Now we're three restaurants. I know
it's a flask.
But we truly appreciate you guys. So here's a 12-pack. Anybody wants to try?
Whoa! Whoa!
Oh, thank you.
Everybody, hey, right now, everybody. Hey, love you, Eddie Santiago! Anybody who's online on Facebook right now, please, please take this to heart. Giardino, right off Braddock. In Springfield, we've got Villa Bella, which is right down here by Dunkin' Donuts, and the Haircuttery, which, as you can tell, I have not been to. This is unbelievable. I have not had this long hair since I was in high school, and it's fabulous. And then also Paradiso in Alexandria near Springfield, where we go and play all the time. So please, please follow businesses like this and JV's and Kilroy's and Brian's and all the places we play there. I could go on all night about that. And, of course, the bigger venues. This is a song from Bruce Springsteen. He is my Lord and Savior to a certain extent. I've loved his music since I can remember it, since I was about 17. I remember the first moment that I fell in love with his music. This is from an album called The Rising, and he put it out after 9/11. It was an incredible record, and he also played D.C. about 5 months after this record. And I've seen Bruce about 35 times, and it was the most emotional show he's ever done. And people were just in tears with joy, and you know, he was just really. And this song is kind of getting you out of it. And so what we're going to do is bring it out to this day. I'm glad everybody's here and socially distancing. There are masks here. I love to see. Please be safe. Nobody wants to be home all the time or not be at their work or businesses, but we have to be careful. It spikes if you screw up. That's what we've seen. So this is called Waiting on a Sunny Day.
Yeah, go ahead, try one. Someone's got to break open the box.
Attaboy, atta man. Way to go, brother. The sky must have been a tear from your eye. Everything will be okay. It's funny, thought I felt a sweet summer breeze. Must have been your sighing so deep. Don't worry, gonna find a way. Well, I'm waiting on a sunny day, gonna chase the clouds away, waiting on a sunny day. Well, without you, I'm working with the rain falling down. I'm half a party in a one-dog town. I need you to blues away. Well, without you, I'm a drummer girl who can't keep her feet. I'm an ice cream truck on a deserted street. I hope that you're coming to stay. Come on, y'all. Well, I'm waiting, waiting on a sunny day. I'm gonna chase the clouds away. Waiting on a sunny day. All right, Suzanne, it's the Greek. Hard times, baby, will they come to us all? Sure as the ticking of the clock on the wall. sure as the turning of the night into day, right? But your smile, girl, brings a morning light to my eyes. It lifts away the blues when I rise. Well, I hope that you're coming to stay. All right, everybody. Well, I'm waiting, waiting on a sunny day. Gonna chase the clouds away. Come on. Waiting on a sunny day. All right, everybody. Well, I'm waiting, waiting on a sunny day. All right. Gonna chase the clouds away. Jersey. Waiting on a sunny day. All right, D.C., Maryland. I'm waiting, waiting on a sunny day. Gonna chase the clouds away. I'm waiting on a sunny day. You guys clapped and got into it. I love you.
Yes.
That is the man. What a wonderful thing to do that that song.
It's a wonderful life.
Thanks. It's a wonderful life.
I don't really need these anymore.
No.
Although, when I went to Costco to get my new glasses about 8 months ago, I didn't ask for tinted. So now I'm like, well, I don't need my sunglasses. Then these tint in the outdoors, and I'm like, well, okay. It's all good. This is a song we attempted last week, and it's one of our favorite songs to play, and it's just, we've been doing this for 2 months for you guys who are hopping in on this. Susanna's a classically trained clarinetist for the last 30, 40 years, more. Plays in the Main Street Band. I've only been singing for about 15 years in cover bands around here, and Susanna, I said, maybe you should, can you pick up that guitar? What do you, she's like, maybe I should pick up the guitar. So she picked it up 2 months ago, and the Greek and the Freak were born.
Bought a guitar, yes! Bought a guitar, bought an amp.
Yeah, really, she's bought more equipment than I've bought in 15 years. I borrow it from my bands. This monitor's borrowed from the band, this mic stand, this mic is mine.
We needed a guitar.
But she went and got all this equipment, and we went to Bethany this past 3 days just to get out of town. We have a place on the bay, and went out and just to get out of town. You're not supposed to really go there unless you're quarantined for 14 days, but we didn't leave the house. I mean, we stayed in the community, walked the dogs, played a little golf, and that's it, and didn't see anybody, promise. But we went and we brought all this gear that you see with us and rehearsed last night. We actually did a song live to tease tonight, but love you. Thank you for all that you've done to save my own sanity. And Flo knows, and any other musician in this group, Fred, Lori, all you guys who play, know how tough this has been on you, not only if it's your career, but just your soul to wanting to play. So this song is one of my favorites. It's by a band, actually, again, delving out of our comfort zone. We'll see if we can pull it off. It's been a while since I could hold my head up high, and it's been a while since I first saw you. And it's been a while since I could stand on my own 2 feet again, and it's been a while since I could call you. And everything I can't remember is fucked up as it all may seem. Consequences that I've rendered, I stretched myself beyond my means. And it's been a while since I can say that I wasn't addicted And it's been a while since I can say I love myself as well. And it's been a while since I've gone and fucked things up just like I always do. And it's been a while, but all that shit seems to disappear when I'm with you. And everything I can remember is fucked up as it all may seem. Consequences that I rendered. I've gone and fucked things up again. Why must I feel this way? Just make this go away. It's just one more peaceful day. Ah, yeah. And it's been a while since I could look at myself straight. And it's been a while since I said I'm sorry. And it's been a while since I've seen the way the candles light your face. And it's been a while, but I can still remember just the way you taste. And everything I can remember as fucked up as it all may seem to be, I know it's me. I cannot blame this on my father. Did the best he could for me. And it's been a while since I could hold my head up high. And it's been a while since I said I'm sorry. Oh my. We go deep. We go frivolous and deep. There's many frivolous songs coming.
That's a DC 101 song.
That is a beauty. By Stained. Wow. I do a Stained song called Outside with another band. That I'm another duo, Jess Robinson, my dear, dear friend, who I miss terribly too. We play all the time, and we do Outside, but that's a great band, Stained. This is another one of my most favorite people in music, Eddie Vedder. Eddie did an incredible soundtrack for Into the Wild, which is about Chris McCandless. Went to Woodson High School. The whole book and movie were about Chris and his family, and Chris decided, I've had it. I don't want to be around all these people, my fucked up parents and society and all that. So he split, and it hurt his sister and it hurt his parents, but he had to do what he had to do, and he ended up not surviving. But Eddie was asked to write the soundtrack to the film that Sean Penn directed, and there's so many good songs, guys. Go, if you like Eddie's voice, you like Pearl Jam, you haven't heard this, oh my God. Spectacular record. It's just him singing largely with acoustic guitar. And this is a little bit more of the raucous song called Heart Sun. When I walk beside her, I am the better man. When I look to leave her, I always stagger back again. Once I built an ivory tower so I could worship from above. When I climb down to be set free, She took me in again. There's a big, big hot sun beating on the big people in a big hot world. When she comes to greet me, she is mercy at my feet. When I see her pin her charm, she just throws it back again. Once I dug an early grave to find a better land, she just smiled and laughed at me and took her blues back again. There's a big, big hot sun beating on the big people in the big hot world. There's a big, big hot sun beating on the big people in the big hard world. When I go to cross that river, she is comfort by my side. When I try to understand, she just opens up her eyes. There's a big, it's a big hard sun beating on the big people in a big hard world. Once I stood to lose her when I saw what I had done. Bound down flew away the hours of her garden and her sun. So I tried to warn her, I turned to see her weep. 40 days and 40 nights and it's still coming down on me. There's a big hot sun beating on the big people in a big hard world. It's a big, oh big, it's a big hard sun beating on the big people in a big hard world. It's a big, a big hard sun beating on the big people in a big hard world. On the big people in a big hard world. No need to throw the tambourine. Suzanne going on the last page without looking. That's anytime I sing Eddie, we do Society also tonight, so you're going to get a little more Eddie from Into the Wild. Anytime I get to do Pearl Jam, they are to me one of the great American bands of all time, and what a ride. You know, he was working at a Chevron gas station, Eddie Vedder, and kind of a fledgling singer, didn't do anything, surfing and working at a gas station, and somebody got wind of and Pearl Jam got wind of him and sent him a cassette, and he got in the car and drove down to LA from San Francisco, and the rest is Hall of Fame history. What a great band. I love those guys. Speaking of great artists, when I was young and growing up in Wilton, Connecticut, my parents had a number of albums, probably about 100, and that's a lot. All vinyl, obviously, and some 8-track, but mostly vinyl. And one of the great records, one of the records that they had that they played all the time in our little barn was King of the Road by Roger Miller. And Roger Miller was really one of the astounding artists of our time. He was in the country music Ken Burns documentary and really had a nice chunk of time in there. And this song is just kind of, it epitomizes Roger, and it epitomizes kind of his little offbeat style. This is a title track to his record called King of the Road. And I'm going to ask you, how many people, like, I click really oddly. See, like, I click fingers on the first three instead of this. Isn't that odd? And Suzanne's busted my tail for a long time, legitimately, because nobody does that, right? Do you snap like that? How do you guys snap? How do you guys snap? You snap like that? Yeah. I'm like, what am I doing piling three fingers on? But it's the way I roll. So this song, God, my hair, this is just insane. I didn't want Suzanne to cut it because I'm not vain, but I didn't really want it. And I miss Nikki from Vietnam, who works at a hair cuttery. She's so sweet. And she, what's really amazing is about mid-February, she's like, I'm going to be gone until late March. I'm going home to Vietnam and visit my family. And I'm like, okay, I'll see you when you get back. Back. So my hair has grown more than the weeds around this little electric thing. And it's fine. We're fine.
Let's all hear your
right,
snapping.
So enough of that.
We're going to hear your snapping now.
There we go. Oh, hold on. I need some hand sanitizer. Is that a San Francisco Giants hat? Dude, are you from San Francisco?
I wish.
Why do you like them?
I went to a baseball game there.
Oh, great. Well, they are the dynasty among dynasties in baseball. Willie Mays, Willie McCovey, some of the great players. I'm a huge baseball fan, so I love seeing that hat. All right, here we go with the snap. Trailers for sale or rent, rooms to let 50 cents. There's no phone, no pool, no pets. I ain't got no cigarettes. But 2 hours of pushing broom. It buys a 8x12 4-bedroom. I'm a man of means by no means. Come on, king of the road. Third boxcar midnight train, where destination Bangor, Maine. Old worn out clothes and shoes, I don't pay no union dues. I smoke old stogies I have found. They're short but not too big around. I'm a man of means by no means, king of the road. I know every engineer on every train, all of the children and all of the names, and every handout in every town, and every lock that ain't locked when no one's around. I sing trailers for sale or rent, room to make 50 cents. No phone and no pools and no pets. Ain't got no cigarettes. I've been 2 hours of a pushing some broom. Buys an 8x12 4-bedroom. I'm a man of means by no means, king of the road. All right, everybody. Trailers for sale or rent. Snap. Room
Please.
To make 50 cents. There's no phone and no pools and no pets. I ain't got no cigarettes. But 2 hours of pushing broom. It buys you 8x12 4-bedroom. I'm a man of means by no means, king of the road. Thanks for the snapping aid, since I'm so incredibly lame.
I know, it's never snapped. It's always clicking.
Well,
and
why do you do that? Yeah.
I know, it's odd, isn't it, Fran?
Well, what really matters is he can sing, right? He can sing.
Yeah, really.
Snapping will let him.
That's been my whole life. It's like, well, let's not look at those flaws. Let's look at what he can do.
That's great.
I can do my knuckles.
Oh,
we want to thank Carrie next door
for this beautiful gift.
Yes.
And when we walked up there, there is, I'll tell you, it's Bacardi. It is, I already looked at these.
It's Kraken, it's Black Label, it's Jameson, and your favorite, the Bullet Bourbon, in little airplane size bottles with a note, a little something to keep you going. Love your adoring fans. Let's give Carrie a hand and let's thank everybody for going out and seeing live music. Flo Anito. Can't wait to go see you again live. So thanks so much. That was very sweet. And I'm going to open one of these in a minute and drink the whole thing, but we'll wait a second. Right, Susan?
Did you finish your hand sanitizer?
No, my hand sanitizer is still doing well. This was the mini one. It was given to me by a friend on my birthday, and she gives it to me, and it's two hand sanitizer things, and I'm like, oh, you're very sweet. And we were playing JVs, I was like, well, that's sweet, because it was before the pandemic hit, and I'm going, well, okay, I guess we're set. And she's like, no, they're not. It's not hand sanitizer. Because what it does is there's a little thing you put on that looks like it's sealed, so you can travel. And I'm like, wow, people really have to be wanting to pound to have that. But I'm here, so. But I don't have to put the little top thing on. It's just at home. But I thought that was an interesting thing. Thank you again, sweetie. All right, this is a song we hadn't done last weekend. We haven't done it in a little while. It's a beautiful song written by John Denver, but epitomized by Peter, Paul, and Mary. One of the more beautiful songs. Also reminds me of my beautiful parents, who I lost 3 weeks apart in 2004, and I miss them. I'm an only child, so I am an orphan. I feel like Oliver. Where is love? Does it fall from skies above? I saw that movie 8 times when it came out. Because it was consider yourself well-in. And
oh my God.
We might break into an Oliver medley. And then everybody's going to stream to the end of the Pipestem. To Eddie's trunk. By the way, if you've wandered in, that 12-pack is sitting there for anybody's choice. It is amazing. Eddie Santiago, thank you so much. I think we're still live. It looks like we are. Oh, great. But what matters is you guys sitting here, especially you guys all right here and all there and everybody. Just love it. All right, here we go.
Is this a cold end?
Yes.
One, two, three. All my bags are packed. I'm ready to go. I'm standing here outside your door. I hate to wake you up to say goodbye, but the dawn is breaking, it's early morn. My taxi's waiting, he's blowing his horn. Already I'm so lonesome I could die. So kiss me and smile for me. Tell me that you'll wait for me. Hold me like you'll never let me go. 'Cause I'm leaving on a jet plane. Don't know when I'll be back again. Oh, babe, I hate to go. Now the time has come, come to leave you. One more time and I've played around. I tell you now, they don't mean a thing. 'Cause every place I go, I think of you. Every song I sing for you. When I come back, I'll bring your wedding ring. Come on! So kiss me and smile for me. Tell me that you'll wait for me. Hold me like you'll never let me go. 'Cause I'm leaving on a jet plane. Don't know when I'll be back again. Oh, babe, I hate to go. All right, now I'll do this right, Larry. Now the time has come to leave you one more time. Let me kiss you, close your eyes, and I'll be on my way. I'll dream about the days to come when I won't have to leave alone. About the times I won't have to say. Oh, kiss me and smile for me. All right. Tell me that you'll wait for me. Hold me like you'll never let me go. 'Cause I'm leaving on a jet plane. Don't know when I'll be back again. Leaving on a jet plane. Don't know when I'll be back again. Leaving on a jet plane. Don't know when I'll be back again. Thanks for singing along, Flo. Thanks for everybody, you guys. Carrie, I saw you singing every note there. Anybody who misses somebody who's away or flies away, there you go. That's a beauty. It's already a beauty. We quote this skit, we probably won't go into it, but Saturday Night Live, Scott's skits called Meet Your Second Wife.
Look it up.
Just Google it. I'm not going to go into it. And I saw it about 5 years ago, and I play it like 1,000 times a year. It's Amy Poehler and Tina Fey are the hosts of a game show, and it's...
And they're meeting their second wife.
Yeah, I can't even go into it. But, yeah, I could do the whole skit here, and you'd be bored. And let's just sing. So this guy made a huge gamble in his career about 15 years ago, Darius Rucker, and he went country, which for an African American gentleman is a big jump. Charlie Pride did it. My buddy Cleve Francis. I was supposed to sing at the Birchmere April 25th for the first time. Can you believe that? This goofy cover band guy was going to sing backup for Cleve Francis, who was one of the great country singers of the 90s, and it got canceled. But Darius Rucker took a gamble and actually hit pay dirt and became a huge, huge star in country music. But his roots go to Cracked Rear View. She sits alone on a lamppost, trying to find the thoughts that's escaped her mind. She says, Dad's the one I love the most, but old Stipe's not far behind. She never lets me in, only tells me where she's been when she's had too much to drink. I say that I don't care, I just run my hands through her dark hair. Then I pray to God, you gotta help me fly away and just let her cry. And the tears fall down like rain, let her sing. If it eases all her pain, let her go. Let her walk right out on me. And if the sun comes up tomorrow, let her be. Let her be. If you know it, sing along. This morning I woke up alone, found a note standing by the phone, saying, baby, maybe, maybe I'll be back someday. I wanted to look for you, you walked right in, I didn't know just what to do. So I sat back down, had a beer, and felt sorry for myself, saying, let her cry. And the tears fall down like rain, let her sing. If it eases all her pain, let her walk right out on me. And if the sun comes up tomorrow, let her be. Let her be. Won't you let her be? Last night I tried to leave, I cried so much I could not believe. She left her the same girl I knew long ago. She went in the back to get high, I sat down on my couch and cried, yelling, oh mama, please help me, won't you hold my hand and let her cry. If the tears fall down like rain, let her sing. If it eases all her pain, let her go. Let her walk right out on me. And if the sun comes up tomorrow, let her be. Oh, let her cry. Let the tears fall down like rain. Let her sing. If it eases all her pain, let her go. Let her walk right out on me. And if the sun comes up tomorrow, let her be. letter.
Oh, nice.
Hootie and the Blowfish. That's a beauty. It's already a beauty. We quote that because it's in that wife thing. So that's kind of a thing. So much. Cheers to all of you guys. All of you here. Wonderful neighbors. We've seen you guys out doing lawn work every day and kicking ass over here. Yeah, I mean, and that one of the most beautiful lawns in the entire region.
Shame.
Putting us to shame. I'm like, I got to get home and mow. And then I got out here the other day, and the mower broke down. And so Fred Rosen, ladies and gentlemen, speaking of Fred Rosen, seven or something. All right. But what a wonderful set. And Fred kicked off tonight with this beautiful set. He's a wonderful sax player. And we were talking earlier, Fred, about the fact that maybe Suzanne kind of helped you kind of bounce back into playing sax a little bit.
You betcha. He's not.
And I love that. Well, that's the point.
It only took 3 years, right, Fred?
And Fred, I love going to see the Main Street Community Band because I actually know five members of the band. Suzanne's in a clarinet quartet called The Four Winds, which is fabulous. They play everything from like, what's the Sting guy, Scott?
Scott Joplin.
Scott Joplin and all that stuff. And just, but wonderful stuff. Like they did
the theme from the Mario Brothers.
Mario Brothers on clarinet. It was like, but it's clarinets, and you're like, what? And I never really played it, although one summer I did in Chincoteague, and I was like, did it, but I wasn't a video game guy. But anyway, Fred, what a beautiful set. And
oh my God.
Yeah. So I'm going to share that galore. This is a song, we played it for the last few gigs online. And outside, written by Roland Orzabal from Tears for Fears, and then rejuvenated for an amazingly bizarre and unforgettable film called Donnie Darko, which was with Jake Gyllenhaal and just an incredible, I can't even describe it. But this song got a rebirth in 2001, and it's a beautiful song. It kind of fits right now, but please sing along in the chorus. If you feel motivated, but it's a beautiful song called Mad World. Are familiar faces, worn out places, worn out faces, bright and early for the daily races, going nowhere, going nowhere. Their tears are really filling up their glasses. No expression, no expression. I hide my head, I wanna drown my sorrow. But no tomorrow, no tomorrow. And I find it kinda funny, I find it kinda sad. The dreams in which I'm dying are the best I've ever had. Find it hard to tell, hard to take. Would be very, very mad world, mad world. Children waiting for the day they feel good. Happy birthday, happy birthday. I'm made to feel the way that every child should. Sit and listen, sit and listen. Son, I went to school and I was very nervous. No one knew me, no one knew me. Well, hello teacher, tell me what's my lesson. She looked right through me, looked right through me. And I find it kind of funny, find it kind of sad. The dreams in which I'm dying are the best I've ever had. I find it hard to tell you, I find it hard to take. When people run in circles, it's a very, very mad world. Mad world. enlarge your world, 'cause it's a mad world, mad world, mad world. Enlarge your world, 'cause it's a mad world. Roland Orzabal. Again, we are the messengers. These, if I did original music, I would say take credit. We are the messengers for these people. So go out and find that. And that was Gary Jules and William Andrews who did that cover. Oh, my God. And that fits the movie. And now I can't stop seeing the plane through the roof and the rabbit. And right? And oh, my God. What a film. Bizarre as hell. It took me like 5 viewings to really know what they did. This song, comes from one of my favorite films of all time, by one of my favorite duos of all time, one of our favorite duos. If we could do more of their music, we would, but it was always largely the two of them doing the songs together. But this is a beautiful song, really fun song, actually, from a movie called The Graduate. It's my son's name is Benjamin, so I hope he never gets into that predicament when he walks in and falls for an older lady who falls for him, and then and Catherine Ross, had the biggest crush on her from Butch Cassidy and The Graduate. But what a great song. And sing along, please, if you would.
Isn't that what I'm doing now?
Thanks so much again for hanging in the Pipestem, you guys. It's literally a huge joy, and I hope it brings you some joy kind of coming out and hanging. You guys sitting in the driveway on the blankets is so wonderful. It's just fabulous, and I hope that for, not for long we'll be able to get out and do some stuff, but right now this is what brings us joy, and I hope we bring you some joy tonight. And I just see Anne Bancroft sitting on that couch going, Benjamin. And here's to you, Mrs. Robinson. Jesus loves you more than you will know. Whoa, whoa, whoa. God bless you, please, Mrs. Robinson. Heaven holds a place for those who pray. Hey, 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 come on. Hey, 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 boom, boom, boom. Boom, boom, boom. We'd like to know a little bit about you for our files. We'd like to help you learn to help yourself. Look around you, all you see are sympathetic eyes. Stroll around the grounds until you feel at home. And here's to you, Mrs. Robinson. Jesus loves you more than you will know. Whoa, whoa, whoa. God bless you, please, Mrs. Robinson. Heaven holds a place for those who pray, right? Hey, hey, hey. Hey, hey, hey. Boom, boom, boom. Boom, boom, boom. Hide it in a hiding place when no one ever goes. Put it in your pantry with your cupcakes. It's just a little secret, just a Robinson's affair. Most of all, you've got to hide it from the kids. Coo-coo-ca-choo, Mrs. Robinson. Jesus loves you more than you will know. Come on. Whoa, whoa, whoa. God bless you, please, Mrs. Robinson. Heaven holds a place for those who pray. Hey, 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 ha. Hey, 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 boom, boom, boom. Boop-a-da-boom, boom, boom. Sitting on a sofa on a Sunday afternoon. Going to a candidate's debate, uh-oh. Laugh about it, shout about it, when you've got to choose. Every way you look at it, you lose. Jody!
Where have you gone, Joe DiMaggio? Our nation turns its lonely eyes to you. And Norma Jean, woo, woo, woo. Garments to say, Mrs. Robinson, it's Jolton Joe. He's left and gone away, right? Hey, 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 hey. Boom, 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 boom. Chicka, 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 boom, 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 boom. Oh, come on. Boom, boom, boom. Boom, 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 boom.
It's getting into the songs. Like, we've tried to do that a couple times live, and here's to you. Hello.
I just give them the notes. That's all. We're good. We're good.
Once again, I think we're live. Anybody on Facebook knows our page. Dial us up, see if we're still there. It's dimmed a little, but that's probably because of the lighting and stuff. We don't care. We're here for you in the Pipestem. That's all that matters is you guys sitting right here. Really, that's all that matters. It's just amazing to see your faces. What is that hat? Is that a Patagonia hat? Yeah, okay. I'm just looking at hats, looking at people, fountainhead shirts, things, dogs in laps, flag blouses or whatever, tees. So good to be out here with you guys. My sanitizer is running out, but oh, gosh. There's a little bit of a supply here, thanks to neighbor, 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 neighbor. We could do the Stone song. Neighbor, what was your neighbor? We did a Stones. I'm in a Stones cover band. It's been a while. I'm only in 10 bands because it's idiotically obsessive. But the Stones cover band was a blast. We've done about half a dozen gigs, and wow. And I don't try to be Mick the whole time, but you can't help it. Speaking of legends, this is a beautiful song. He wrote this apparently for his wife, Claudette, and she was going out to shop or going out at night to do something, not going out, you know, with people other than him. She loved Roy Orbison. But he said, well, I'm just going to write this song for you. You. And he did.
You're still alive, Steve. I just checked.
Thank you.
Thank you, darling. Pretty woman, walking down the street. Pretty woman, the kind I'd like to meet. Pretty woman, I don't believe you, you're not the truth. No one could look as good as you. Mercy. Pretty woman, won't you pardon me? Pretty woman, can't help but see. Pretty woman, that you look lovely as you can. Pretty woman, stop a while. Pretty woman, talk a while. Pretty woman, give your smile to me. Pretty woman, yeah, yeah, yeah. Pretty woman, look my way. Pretty woman, say you'll stay with me. 'Cause I need you. They'll treat you right. Come with me, baby. Be mine tonight. Pretty woman, don't walk on by. Pretty woman, don't make me cry. Pretty woman, don't walk away, hey. Okay, if that's the way it must be, okay. I guess I'll go on home, it's late. There'll be tomorrow night. But wait, what do I see? Is she walking back to me? Yeah, she's walking back to me. Pretty woman. Thank you so much. That is, I need to grip down below for that one. Whatever that means.